Hello fellow tankers, in this video I will present you a few strategic tips on the Japan map and followed by gameplay with a pretty funny ending. So this map belongs to the horizontal class of domination map, being that if you have watch a few of my videos, you understand this concept. Horizontal in sense that the three caps are at equal distance from the two spawns, contrary to what I would call the vertical domination map, where essentially one cap would be very close to each spawn, and there would be one central cap, which would be the main concern of the two teams. These vertical maps are essentially very similar to conquest map, because you have essentially only to fight for the central cap. So this Japan map is an horizontal map, and like many horizontal maps, as I mentioned before, you have two connected caps in the sense that they are very easy to attack and defend together, and a more isolated cap because of this big mountain here, sea, on this map. Once you are on sea, it's actually hard to, I mean, it takes time to go back to B, and you have probably to fight some other people to get there, whereas the access or the fight for A and B essentially are made by the same players. So in the beginning of the game, my advice is that you don't try to cap A, because from both sides you will have very soon people coming from the high grounds, and which will be able to see you, especially in arcade. So if you want a fast cap in the beginning of the game, my advice is that you go to B, and B still remains the most important cap. Essentially, again, if you control B, you will have the best chance to ultimately control A. And again, C is essentially irrelevant. I'll come to C a bit later. So when you are on B, if you are going to B from the green side, my advice is that you stay on the right side, on the east side of B. The left side of B is very dangerous, because you can be sniped by the red tanks from here very easily, whereas the right side is well protected, so you can actually try to eliminate the other enemies on B. From the right side, the only spot where you have to be a bit careful is the people who would be camping here, but again, you have a pretty good cover if you go to the corner, and you can actually you have a better position than them, but you have to be aware of these people. From the red side, it's a bit the contrary. You should rather stay on the west side of B, and you can actually of course shoot at people who would be on B, so you can actually sometimes pop up from here and shoot at the people here or here. But you have also a very good position to shoot at campers from here. From the red side, you have really to be careful about campers here, which have an extremely good position, and which makes actually this east side of B very dangerous from the red side. If you have people here, they can actually really put a lot of pressure on B. As you know, I'm not a fan of camping, but I have to admit that right here, you have very good camping spots for the green side. Whereas for the red side, honestly, this camping spot here is okay, but it's not as dangerous as people camping from here. So either in the beginning of the game go toward B, but the most important area on this map is this area, and my advice is that from the green side, I mean a few tanks, not more than two tanks should go to B, but most tanks should try to control this area. And in this area, green has a little advantage because the best spot for green is here behind this mountain, where they can contain the people, the red tanks coming from here, but they can actually also shoot at B. That's a very effective spot to attack and defend B. And in particular, you can attack the people on the west side of B. So you see that if green is not too stupid, if you have one or two campers here, plus people who have advanced fast enough here to shoot at B, will be very hard to keep for the red side. That means that the red side should not just stay here when trying to control the air and this area. That's a very, really too passive way of fighting. So don't stay just in this area when you are red. Try really to push the tanks which are here, and if there are none, really try to advance and actually to come here to prevent enemy tanks, green tanks, from coming out from this passage here. So essentially, you can control, you can cap A only once a side has clamped this area. Of course, you can take advantage of smoke and stuff like that, but really the main focus on this map is to control the hills. Alright, so let me mention C briefly. Here the battle is pretty straightforward. From the red side, this spot here is very popular, but is honestly not very effective. My advice is that you actually advance towards C. From the green side, it can be interesting to come a bit to the east here, and or to go to the sea. So as I mentioned, the domination version of the maps is essentially irrelevant. The only reason why some people should go to sea, not necessarily again to cap it, is to contain enemies who would actually aim for the spawn. If the red side has control B, my advice is that you don't go for their spawn. I mean, you have to be careful about tanks exiting from their spawn, but you try to flank and actually shoot at B from the back. That's a pretty effective strategy, especially in RB. So that means that the green side should not completely neglect C, because then it can be quite a trouble. Same for the red side, of course. If the green side has control C and is starting to push, the east spawn, east red spawn, will be in danger. So that means that essentially going to C, the main focus is to defend the two spawns, and maybe sometimes to flank B. But again, on this map, the main focus is A and B, and in particular the hills between A and B. So let me start this gameplay. When I'm playing in squad, I usually go to B because I'm pretty familiar with fighting there. But since I'm playing alone, I'm playing from the south side, I'm going at once to the spot I mentioned, which is a very, very, very good spot, and which should really be the focus of the green side. And of course, the focus of the red side would be to prevent too many green tanks to go there. Let's see. I think that this illustrates the fact that trying to cap A too soon is a mistake. So in this battle, I think that a bit too many of our team went to C. Not enough in this area between A and B. I'm essentially alone, and that's definitely a mistake. I'm seeing some tanks on B, and unfortunately, I was still looking at my map when this T-30 emerged. So it's not a very good start. But he dies. And again, since there are not too many people in our team there, and B is not yet controlled by our team, I'm deciding to go back to this spot. So, funny part of this replay, I see the guy who killed me, who I checked his stat, he's not too bad, and he's in a dangerous tank, T-34, so I'm doing a ruthless revenge rocketing, and then that guy started to to insult me in the chat, and later in the personal message. Well, you have people complaining about revenge bombing. Have to grow up. It's a game where your aim is to kill people. If someone kills you, don't rage. That's the actual point of the game. Honestly, every time I receive 8 messages for killing someone, I'm really. And it happens a lot. I'm really surprised that people still think that killing an enemy is deserving a rage fit in a game where it's actually the point of the game. So here I had a bad second tank. So that's definitely not of my best gameplay, but I'll show it. I mean, to illustrate, of course, the importance of this AB side. And as you will see, I will also show you, unfortunately, an episode which happens a bit too often in this game. So don't, of course, see this tutorial is not aiming at teaching you how to fly. I'm a very bad pilot, I barely don't fly. So here, some two guys are pushing our spawn. Oops. I'm a bit surprised that M18 is terrorizing. Guys here. Here it goes. I'm now going for the M46. And at this point, you could say that the game is in a good shape. We control two caps, and we have cleaned the area between A and B. You see that when you clean the area between A and B, someone tried to go behind A. It's useless, and you definitely don't go in this area. At this point, our team could probably cap A, but so here I'm doing again one more of my useless bombings, and really to make progress there. See, our team now can cap A completely safely, and that's the end of the game, where essentially, well, the enemy team has collapsed, and this late spawn killing that will start is not a problem. As I mentioned already in the abandoned factory video, where it was our side who was actually late spawn killed. And here I'm killing slowly but surely the T-26. And well, you don't see the chat box, but I'm saying, what the fuck? What are you doing? I got the explanation only later. I presumably stole his kill. And yes, you know, it happens that this T-26 was belonging to this guy, which I duly reported for team killing. You notice that I don't care about him. I'm still trying to shoot, but he's ramming me. My tank is broken. And I die. Thank you, Black Wolf Noob. You are really a great player. So, I thank you for watching this gameplay. Obviously, we won the game. The enemy team is essentially gone. Let me just advertise the two tutorials pinned on the Academy section of the forum. The links are in the description. And I thank you for watching this tutorial and this gameplay. See you in battle.